You may not have heard of Raijintek, but they're turning into a company to look out for. Howdy howdy guys, Ponchato here, and today we'll be taking a look at the LETO CPU cooler from Raijintek. I'll be comparing it to the stock Ryzen 3 cooler, AMD's Wraith Stealth, and overclocking my Ryzen 3 1200 as high as it'll go. At its core, the LETO is a totally black-coated, slim 120mm CPU cooler. With the fan installed, it's 76mm deep, 122mm wide, and only 159mm tall. This allows it to fit into tighter micro ATX cases like this Masterbox Lite 3.1 from Cooler Master. The heatsink is a CPU direct contact design. The three heat pipes are right up against the processor. On top of this, it's compatible with all modern sockets, LGA 1151, 2011, AM3, AM4, and the mounting brackets are included. No need to buy a separate kit. The fan is 120mm, PWM controlled, and operates between about 800rpm and 1800rpm. Raijintek states the airflow is 67 cubic feet per minute max and 1.2 millimeters of H2O for static pressure. The most important feature, of course, is the LEDs. The LETO comes with white, blue, or red LEDs. The nice thing is that they're mounted in the hub of the fan rather than the outer chassis. This tends to more evenly light the blades and looks a bit better. A feature I really love is that in addition to the typical metal wire fan mounts, the LETO comes with rubber fan mounts. This isolates the fan's vibration from the heatsink, which really helps to minimize noise. The fan's chassis and blades have a pretty unique design, and it's certainly a change from the typical square box with curved blades. A little more edgy, if you prefer. I doubt this affects performance very much, but I do think it looks pretty sweet. The box itself has a big picture of the LETO on the front, with all the specifications on the back. As you can see here, the LETO is compatible with basically every consumer CPU socket from the last 10 years. On the side, you'll see pictures of the three models, W, R, and B, for the white LEDs, red LEDs, or blue LEDs, respectively. The one I'm reviewing here is the blue model. On top, you'll find a small summary of features and benefits unique to the LETO. Inside, you'll find two bags with the various hardware for mounting, a small bag with the screws and rubber mounts, and a larger bag with the backplate and brackets for AMD and Intel systems. The installation guide, heatsink, and fan are below a small cardboard divider. The installation guide comes in just about any language you could need. English, German, French, Spanish, Italian, Japanese, Chinese, Russian, Turkish, and Portuguese. I know this is standard, but I really do appreciate how companies are doing this these days. It makes it a lot easier for people outside the US, UK, and Australia. Raijintek includes a list of mounting hardware with names and pictures. I love this. Everyone should be doing this. It makes it so much easier for complicated installations. Not that the LETO was that difficult to install. I found the instructions to be easy to follow and well written. The pictures are clear and the instructions are simple and straightforward. On to the installation. After removing the stock cooler and the backplate from the Ryzen 3 and cleaning up the CPU with some isopropyl alcohol and cotton swabs, I got ready to install the LETO. The first step was to install the new backplate. Some people have complained about this being difficult, but I didn't really have any trouble. I lined up the mounting holes in the backplate with those in the motherboard, put the screws through, and then fastened it all together with the plastic riser nuts that Raijintek provides. The easiest way to do this is just press a finger against each screw head while you're putting on the plastic risers. You do have to be careful not to over-tighten the plastic nut since it is a pretty fine thread, but those are just for spacing and holding it together during installation anyway. The real solid connection is made with metal nuts later in the install. Once the backplate is installed and fastened down, the next step is to install the mounting brackets. Two sets of brackets are provided, one for Intel systems and one for AMD, though the installation process is essentially identical for both. The process for LGA 2011 is a little different, but the mounting hardware you need is included. After setting the mounting brackets on the screws, I tightened down the nuts to secure them in place. The next step was to apply the included thermal paste. Like most coolers, Raijintek gives you just enough for one installation. I squeezed it out in a blob in the center so as to prevent any air bubbles from getting trapped. The base of the heatsink is pretty much perfectly smooth, so this method will work best. And just don't forget to take off the protective plastic sticker on the bottom. Next, the crossbar goes between the fins and the base. This is the part that holds the heatsink down. It has two little raised nubs that fit into two sockets on top of the base, so lining it up is pretty easy. I do want to note this, on AM4 systems the LETO can only be installed horizontally, with the fan blowing up or down. I wouldn't consider this to be a problem with the cooler itself, but rather that AMD chose not to have a square mounting pattern. The good news is it should barely affect performance, if it does at all. It'd just be nicer to have the fans and its LEDs facing forward. This horizontal position could be a problem if you have memory with tall heatsinks. There are only a few millimeters of clearance above my memory. The other thing is, since it covers the DIMM slot closest to the CPU, you'll want to leave your memory installed, unlike what I did here. This won't be a problem on Intel systems since the mounting hole pattern is square. It can be turned either way. Once the cooler is in place, the crossbar gets held down with two small screws that screw into the mounting brackets. Once they're tightened all the way down, the cooler is very secure. The final step is installing the fan. First, the rubber screws need to be attached to the fan by pulling the longer section through the fan mounting holes. Once those were in place, I first plugged the fan into the motherboard and then started mounting it to the heatsink. Raijintek recommends that you start with the top rubber screws, push them into the mounting holes on the heatsink, and the fan will be held in place while you install the screws on the bottom. The ones on the bottom were a bit difficult to get to simply because it's a tight space between the bottom of the cooler and the motherboard. The mounting screw right above the memory in particular was a hassle, though because the rubber is very flexible, it eventually went in. With the cooler installed, it was time to start testing. My benchmark process consists of three situations: idle, gaming in CSGO, and stress testing with Prime 95. For each test, I let it run for 15 minutes to allow temperatures to stabilize. For this video, I'll be testing the Ryzen 3 1200 both at stock clocks, 3.1 GHz, and overclocked to 4 GHz. I'll also be comparing the Leto's temperatures with the Ryzen 3 stock cooler, AMD's Wraith Stealth. All testing was performed in a room at 24 degrees Celsius. Here's the graph at stock speeds. The Wraith Stealth idled at 33 degrees Celsius, gamed at 53 degrees, and while stress testing with Prime 95, reached 63 degrees Celsius. Raijintek's Leto idled at 32 degrees Celsius, CSGO ran at 41, and stress testing with Prime 95 topped the Ryzen 3 1200 at 47 degrees. It should be noted that the Leto's fan never went above 900 RPM. When it's spinning that slowly, the Leto is pretty much inaudible above the GPU and power supply fans. It's really, really quiet. So that's the easy test. Now we'll do the hard one. With the Ryzen 3 1200 overclocked to 4 GHz at 1.275 volts, here are the results. At idle, the Wraith Stealth kept it around 35 degrees Celsius. While gaming in CSGO, it reached 57 degrees, and finally, under stress testing, it hit 73 degrees Celsius with the Wraith Stealth running at its max speed of 2000 RPM. At this speed, it isn't annoying, but it is definitely audible and louder than the other components. With the Leto installed, the Ryzen 3 idled at 34 degrees Celsius, gamed at 51, and under stress testing reached 68 degrees while the fan ran at about 1200 RPM, roughly 40% of its max speed. Even during stress testing, the Leto was only slightly louder than the GPU or power supply fans. On top of that, since it's a 120mm fan, it produces noise at lower frequencies than the Wraith Stealth's 92mm fan. Basically, this means in addition to being quieter, the noise that it produces is also less noticeable. Now, what about pushing this Ryzen 3 to its limits? The Leto allows for a much higher thermal overhead, so a higher voltage can be used, which should allow for increased clock speeds. I ran through the overclocking process again to see how far I could get, and actually hit the stability limit of this Ryzen 3 before I ran into the cooling limit of the Leto. Just going from 4 GHz to 4.1 GHz required increasing the voltage 12 steps up to 1.35 volts. The Ryzen 3 simply would not function above 4.1 GHz even when I set the voltage to 1.4, the highest that AMD openly recommends. Still, that's a full 1000 MHz above stock speed. That's not bad. At this slightly higher clock speed and significantly higher voltage, the Ryzen 3 did heat up quite a bit. At idle, it sat around 34 degrees Celsius, while gaming it reached 56, and under stress testing with Prime 95 reached 74 degrees Celsius, with the Leto running at 90% fan speed, around 1700 RPM. It's definitely audible at this speed, but more of a gentle whir than an annoying fan buzz. I'm a bit sad that the Ryzen 3 couldn't go any faster than this, but that's a problem with the chip and not the cooler. Even with an AIO liquid cooler, this 1200 just isn't going any faster. One quick thing I wanted to mention because it's just so odd. The white plastic on the inside of the fan's chassis glows in the dark. When you shut down your computer, you can see this. It's a strange little detail, but if you like glow-in-the-dark stuff, this is probably the only cooler on the market that does it. So for the Raijintek Leto, here is my list of pros and cons. First, the pros. It looks sweet, it's easy to install, rubber fan mounts are awesome, and it's very reasonably priced. As for the cons, it can only be installed horizontally in AM4 systems. Because of this, it may interfere with tall memory. Intel systems won't have this problem. The packaging is flimsy. It doesn't offer much protection, and as you may have noticed in this video, some of the fins got bent. Minor bends like these won't really affect performance, but they do affect the appearance. It's unfortunate because this is a problem with the box, not the cooler itself, and it's something that's easy to fix. In summary, I think this is a really good cooler for the price. It's only about $30 on Newegg as of this upload. The black coating looks great, the fan design is cool, the LEDs work well and aren't obnoxiously bright, and most important, it cools well without being loud. In fact, if you have a fairly cool processor to begin with, the Raijintek Leto is nearly silent. If you're looking for a budget aftermarket cooler with a nice appearance and good performance, I'd recommend checking out the Raijintek Leto. Click the card in the top right or the link in the description to check out my Ryzen 3 overclocking guide. You'll see in depth how I overclocked my Ryzen 3 1200 and how you can do it too. If you want to get notified of new videos as soon as they're up, hit subscribe, then click the bell icon to enable notifications. Links to the Leto cooler and my Ryzen 3 build components are in the description below. So guys, if you like this video, hit the like button. If you want to see more, hit subscribe. And if you have any questions about the Raijintek Leto, leave them in the comments below. Thanks for watching, I hope I helped, and I'll see you in the next video.